morning and welcome to our morning worship for the first Sunday in May. Our theme this morning is very much about shepherds and sheep, but we're going to start with a chorus that you do in fact know, which we have this morning on video, so please do join in.
Faithful one, so unchanging, ageless one, you're my rock of peace, Lord. In times of trouble,
Let's come together in prayer. Jesus says, I am the gate. Come and be loved. Come and receive peace. Come and find life. And now we're going to sing our first hymn together, Take My Life and Let It Be. And once again, many thanks to the Wardour family for playing and singing along with our hymns for this morning, so that I'm not doing a complete solo. And I hope, of course, that you are all joining in where you are. Take my life and let it be. Will already know, and that is that this coming week the reflections will take a form each day of a piece of music or a worship song or a hymn that's one of my favourites, and I'm hoping that there'll be something on at least some of the days for every one of you. I'm having a couple of days off from doing the reflections, but there will be a piece of music every day at 10:30 for you to enjoy with your cup of coffee or your cup of tea or whatever it is, because I know how many of you really appreciate that focus in the middle of your morning. And now, let's come together in prayer. let's remember and silently offer thanks for all the ways in which the Lord provides for us. Rejoice in the rest God offers you in His presence. Commit yourself to be guided by God, to trust in His wisdom. Open yourself to the generosity of God's love, beyond measure, beyond words, beyond our imagining. Praise God that in times of joy and celebration He is with you, and in times of sadness, confusion and loss, He is with you. For all time and in whatever we face, the Lord is our shelter, our security, the place where we will find a home. Thanks be to God. Amen. And you'll see that image there is of an old-fashioned sheepfold. You will see them still in various parts of the world, including in parts of Pembrokeshire. But especially if you go to places like Turkey and the Far East, you'll see this kind of sheepfold where there's one way in and one way out. And the idea of this style of sheepfold is that once the sheep are in, the shepherd lies or sits in the entrance so that nothing can get past to get at his flock. Now, our readings today are a little bit different, and I'm hoping each week to try and have something a bit different. And our readings this week are both being done by people, by doctors in our NHS, in their work clothes, as it were. And so our first reading is from Russell.
So this is The Good Shepherd and His Sheep from John 10. It's starting at the first verse. Very truly I tell you, Pharisees, anyone who does not enter the sheep pen by the gate, but climbs in by some other way, is a thief and a robber. The one who enters the gate by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep listen to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all of his own, he goes on ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. But they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Jesus used this figure of speech, but the Pharisees did not understand what he was telling them. Therefore Jesus said again, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who have come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep have not listened to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. They will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the full."
Thank you for that, Russell. And I hope that this week, due to a few different tweaks and so on, that you will all be able to hear the readings clearly. We've had a few technical issues, but I think I might have sorted that out, because certainly I thought that was lovely and clear. And so we come to the slot that says words for the children. And I've found this little cartoon with that verse that we just heard from Russell. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me. And so there we have our sheep on the field, in the garden, on the sun lounger, with the television on, and a computer on his lap, and a book in his hand and a mask on his eyes and headphones on his ears and a radio on as well by the looks of it and a Bible on the floor beside him and the shepherd here shouting at the top of his voice. I wonder why he can't hear. I wonder why that sheep can't hear the shepherd. I wonder why we sometimes don't hear. I bet you all listen to your parents all the time, don't you? I bet you do exactly what you're asked straight away. And I bet you've heard the phrase selective deafness too, haven't you? Used by one of your parents or your grandparents. You only hear when you want to. Well, I don't think that sheep has got an awful lot of hope of hearing anything with all of that distraction around him. Sometimes we have to take those distractions away, don't we, to be able to hear our shepherd, to be able to hear Jesus. And I'm just going to show you this because I know that you won't be able to see it on the table. At the moment, you know, we are all honouring our key workers, not just our NHS staff, of course, but lots and lots of other key workers. And one of my daughter's colleagues' children has been making these rainbow ribbons and selling them for charity. And she's brought one for me. And I thought I would just show you that because it's a lovely colour, isn't it? Oh, Roger's waving at me because if I come closer, apparently, you'll be able to see it better. Down, down, down. There we are. That's what it looks like. Thank you, Roger. So, just in case you were wondering what that funny little thing on the table was, that's what it is. And now we are going to sing together something that I know many people have, we've learnt it over the last year or so, and I know a lot of our folk, not just the youngsters, really like this. Remember in the middle of it, there's a nice bumpy bit that you can stamp to or clap to if you would like to. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Oh,
going to have our second reading and, of course, probably the best known psalm there is.
Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies and anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long.
I thought it would be a nice idea to have some of our key workers over the next few weeks actually read some of our readings in their work settings for us. And it's such a blessing that ITU at the moment in Morriston isn't chock-a-block full, and Beth was able to find a bay where she could read that. And I understand it was actually appreciated by some people who I think overheard. And so I now have video of, again, something that you know quite well, but it's got some quite nice pictures and things with it too. And I thought you would like to either hear it or join in.
Made this very
Until it was Roger who introduced me to it before our wedding, when he said to me, I think it would be nice if we had this played at our wedding. And it was the Chris Tomlin version, which we all now know, the Chris Tomlin version of Amazing Grace, which we had as part of our wedding ceremony. And that was my introduction to Chris Tomlin, who's become a great favourite ever since, of course. Many of you will recognise that picture. It's an incredibly special place. And I know all of you who've been there, which is many of you who are watching now, I know, would agree with me that it's one of the most special places ever. It's the cross, of course, out on the little headland, a little way away from Faldabrennan, the retreat house in Pembrokeshire, up on the Preseli Hills that we visited many times. Why have I put that there, you're asking yourself? Well, of course, you know the answer, don't you? Faldabrennan, sheepfold of the king. Faldabrennan, sheepfold of the king. And so it seemed appropriate to have a picture today. In fact, there's another one later on because I was being quite indulgent. Well, a few weeks ago, in some parks, farms, coastal paths, and even in gardens of the UK, British sheep have been experiencing a degree of freedom they didn't know before. Even in parks and open spaces where they were being shut down due to the virus, and people were shut into their homes and their own gardens, sheep, and in some places, other animals too, as I'm sure you may have seen on the news, like the goats in North Wales, and the wallabies in parts of Australia, and some rather less desirable neighbours, like alligators in other parts of the world too, I understand, they've taken to roaming about in the newly available space. But rather than wandering aimlessly through the fields, sheep in some places have taken to going to the children's playground and have begun, now wait for it if you haven't already seen this, to play. It appears that their favourite activity is taking turns on the roundabout in the children's play parks. Now, on playing on a roundabout, of course, typically a group of children, or adults, I guess, would sit or stand on it while somebody else pushed it round and round and round until you screamed it was going too fast or something like that. It appears that sheep are a great deal brighter than we thought. Well, actually, I knew. I'll tell you a little story about that if I haven't already years ago. In a 40-acre farm park in Monmouthshire, a flock of sheep was spotted pushing each other on the roundabout in the children's play park for 2 consecutive days. And after that, other sheep were seen also on a playground roundabout in Preston in Lancashire. Now, I don't know about you, but for me, this sort of redefines what it means to be a sheep. And, you know, there's always been this tendency to think of sheep as stupid. But I was disabused of that idea a number of years ago now, and I lived in a farming community, and one of my cats went missing, and she went missing for several days, and I was very worried. Anyway, the long and the short of it is that I went out again into the village to call for her. She was called Megan, to call for her. And I wandered around this very, very quiet little hamlet calling. And there was a field of sheep with a gate onto the little road. And the sheep were going absolutely nuts. They were shouting at me and bleating, and they were really clearly worked up. And I wasn't even that close to them. And I thought, this is funny. So I called again, and the sheep, as if by some miracle, went silent, and I heard the unmistakable call of Megan meowing at me. Opposite where the sheep were in the field, Megan, who had long hair, had got caught in some barbed wire on top of a fence behind a bush, and there she was, stuck. Those sheep, I blessed them that day, and I still do, for leading me to where I needed to go to rescue Megan, who was okay, by the way. So, this week's scriptures are all about sheep. The Hebrew scriptures and the Christian gospels refer to God's people and followers of Jesus as sheep. In the past, as I said, they were referred to as being unintelligent animals that wandered aimlessly and followed each other aimlessly. But you know, one has to wonder that given the opportunity, they will play organised games rather than wander aimlessly. And they rescue errant pet pussycats, that they're maybe not as daft as people always thought. They have, we now realise, a sense of community. Open the gate and the sheep find a new way to play. The human spirit, too, has a natural ability, a natural inclination for making the best of new situations, for making fun out of nothing. You think about it, actually. You put a group of people, not just children, in a place with nothing, apparently, to do and nothing to play with, and they'll find a way. Groups of people will have a game of football with a piece of paper that's rolled up. They will make music with a stick and a tin can. And they do it together. They do it together. When we can't be face to face, still we find ways to connect with each other. And people at the moment are feeling that lack of connection, aren't they? It's a common theme. Years ago, doing things in a roundabout way was not necessarily thought of as positive. But today, it's the mark of heightened innovation. Thinking outside the box, thinking outside the rules, creating new ways to live, new ways to be, new ways to connect. God is the open door that leads to new and exciting pathways. And you know, there is a reality that we most welcome freedom and community when we are most fenced in, when we are most threatened, most fearful, and most alone. When we're fenced in, when we're inhibited, many of us become more creative. God knows we are people who will seek new pathways when gates are opened. And we'll discover new ways of living when the old ways are stymied. Give us the gift of freedom and we'll dare to grasp it. And God gives us the gift of freedom in Jesus, because he opens doors and gates for us when we feel shut in. That phrase in the gospel today, I am the gate, one of the great I am sayings of Jesus. He will lead the way to open fields, to green pastures, to clean waters when we are stagnating. He helps us discover things to eat when our food for living has run out. He girds us up and keeps us strong. He calls us by name so that he can guide us into new pastures when the old ones are running out of good green grass. God's Spirit breathed through us and through our relationship with Jesus gives us that creative, resilient spirit that energizes us and renews us. So to be a sheep is not to be complacent or stupid or aimless or useless. To be a sheep is to be inquisitive, resilient, brave, exploratory. It's to seek out companionship and community and to take advantage of freedom. God offers us what we need to face danger, to come face to face with enemies. Gives us what we need to run in grassy meadows and drink freely of waters, to dare to enter the gate that leads to life in complete and wonderful abundance, to dare to enter the gate and to follow the voice of Jesus, even when we're not sure where we're actually going. And it's because we trust that love and life and play dwell securely in our futures. Psalm 23 is the most beloved psalm of all time, I'm sure. Not just because it's comforting and, of course, vividly beautiful. But, you know, it's a song, of course, of daring and courage, of bravery, of victory. And John's Gospel says the same. No matter how trapped we feel, no matter how fenced in, surrounded by wolves, no matter how confused or worried, no matter what threats lurk outside our walls, when we hear the voice of Jesus, we know that the door, the gate, has been opened. And we have a free invitation to enter in, or indeed to enter out, to go through the gates of life into a new, lush pasture of possibilities. Jesus offers us freedom. Not just from our physical ramparts, but from fear, from solitude, from doubts, from worries, from hunger and thirst, from boredom, from the trappings of inhibition. All we have to do is look for that open door. Jesus is standing beside it, calling us to enter. do we have the courage to enter and discover a new kind of life. Amen. And now we're going to sing together a little bit more of a golden oldie, this, to a lovely Welsh tune. Together in prayer. Loving God, we pray for those whose lives feel empty, for all who feel alone and unloved, whose lives feel as if they lack purpose. Bring them abundant life. We pray for those who are angry or bitter, for those who struggle to let go of the past and so fail to see the good in the present or the hope for the future. We pray for those who are sick or in any kind of pain, for those who are depressed, for those who are afraid and cannot see a way forward. Lord of love, bring them abundant life. We pray for family life. We give thanks for those who love us, for those who care for us and for others. Loving God, may your abundant life fill our world, our church, and us. In the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day. Now our final hymn is one that has become a very great favourite, so I make no apology for the fact that we've had it a few times since lockdown. And that'll be followed by the blessing, and that'll be followed by some music from Rhys and Johan. Blessing, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with each one of you and those you seek to love in his name, now and always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Come yon whore within us unvenefra. Am he had running credit of what I know. A flow of all we sell, the lies in the wound are well.
Russell and Beth and the rest of the Wardour family for what they've done for this service. Thank you.